In today's video, I'm going to show you how to put your video in a circle like this with a nice border around it and also sync it to a screen recording right from your timeline in DaVinci Resolve. Start by placing the footage you want to mask in a circle on video track 2 of the timeline, so it's on a layer above the background screen recording. New tracks will automatically be created for you. Now, to synchronize these, it's as simple as selecting both clips with your mouse with a click and drag, right-click on them, and choose Auto Align Clips. And for this, we'll use Based on Waveform. One of the things with being an editor is you gotta find footage, and you gotta know what drive it's on, and you gotta find it fast. So now that they're synced, I would disable audio on one of the clips by selecting it with the Option key or Alt key on a PC with D for disable, okay? Option D. This is going to mute the clip, but still keep it around later in case you need it. Two tips to be aware of when you sync up clips this way is that one, you need good reference sound on channel one of your clips. So if you have a four-channel audio camera, you know, like the FX3 I'm filming on right now, make sure you're not leaving channel one silent. And number two, you can only sync up one clip per track at a time on the timeline. Next, you're going to add the transform effect to crop the video into a circle. Open the Effects tab in the upper left, click Open Effects, and choose the search bar to start typing the word Transform. You can drag this down to your video clip on layer 2, or sometimes better yet, pro tip, select the clip from the timeline first and then double-click the effect from the effects palette. You'll know it's applied because of the new effects badge on the clip. Open the inspector in the upper right of the edit page and click on the Effects tab property. There are so many parameters to this effect, so to see them all, click the drop-down caret in the upper right to expand the inspector view. And then under Advanced Options, look for Edge Rounding, okay? Edge Rounding is the one we're looking for, and crank the setting all the way over to 1 to make a perfect circle. Edge Rounding 1, you're almost done. Now, if you click on the Video tab in Inspector, you can make a tweak underneath the Transform mask to center and scale up a face using the Position and Zoom sliders for a closer headshot. Now we're going to add a basic fusion shape to outline the circle with a stroke. Now hang with me if you're a fusion newbie like me. This is going to be super simple. Open the media pool and right click to create a new fusion composition. Change the duration for as long as you'd like. I'll change it to 10 minutes, call it outline, and create. Let's place this fusion comp directly above the circle clip on video track 3 with a 3-point edit. Select your circle clip on track 2 and use the keyboard shortcut Shift-A to mark the in and out points on the timeline. Now drag the fusion comp to your timeline viewer and choose Place on Top. You have just precisely dropped the blank fusion comp on top to fill that whole duration. You can always drag and drop and trim with all different kinds of methods. I just wanted to point out that Shift-A command to mark a selected clip because, well, that's new to me and I think it's super cool. Now to actually create the circle, right click on the fusion comp and go down to Open in Fusion page. Let's open the Effects tab over here in Fusion and choose Tools, and then Shape, and then click on S Ellipse, and then also click on S Render. Okay, S Render is basically rasterizing the vector pixels from the ellipse shape node. They should have a yellow connection line between them, but if they don't, just drag from the gray output of the ellipse node to the yellow input of the render node. Now drag from the gray output of the render node to the yellow input of media out, and now we have a circle, fancy, but we wanted an outline, right? Just click the ellipse node, go to the inspector, and uncheck the box for solid, and increase the border width to something around 0.02, and jump to the style tab to change the color. I'm a fan of the banana color. Now that that's set, let's jump back to the edit page to wrap this up. We need to shrink the video clip down a little bit to fit inside our circle, so to do that, choose the Effects tab, and then you can drag the zoom slider down a bit. For extreme precision, double-click the box and use the up and down arrows on your keyboard to zoom in perfectly. The left and right arrows are going to take you to the tens digit for extreme precision. Now, to shrink and position it all down together, select both clips and right-click to create a compound clip. I'll call it Webcam. And this is nesting both of these clips together into a single clip to make it easier to manipulate. In After Effects, this would be considered a pre-comp. To change the scale and position with on-screen controls, click the Transform tool and drag the handles towards the middle to scale the clip down. You can move your mouse to the center and click and drag for moving it anywhere on screen you'd like. Once you're happy with the placement, Click the transform tool again and the controls are gonna go away. To make this compound clip pop even more, go to effects and make sure you're still on open effects and search for drop shadow. Drag the drop shadow effect to the compound clip and you can adjust the strength, the distance, and even the angle. You know, sometimes it's easier to see what you're doing by turning the blur all the way down to zero, then do some tweaks, and then add back some blur. And that's how you put your video inside a circle in DaVinci Resolve. If you found this video helpful at all and want to learn more Resolve tricks, click the playlist or video I have on screen right now for more creative video tips. And because there is so much more to learn, I'm Chadwick, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks so much for watching.